And a lot of question marks about this Oregon team today, Mike Garrett.
No question, Mike. They're wondering what team will the Oregon Ducks field today. They have a lot of key injuries, but the key man is Reggie Ogburn, who's the quarterback. And if he's not in the game, they suffer quite a bit.
Well, we've got a beautiful day for football, temperature in the mid-60s, a great crowd, and we anticipate an outstanding game as USC prepares to do battle against the Oregon Ducks here in Eugene. For football, but it is breezy as the wind is coming in from the west at about 20 miles an hour. Now they're going to have Browner, Joey Browner, hold that ball on the tee so it won't blow off. Eric Kipp is ready, and so are the Ducks, and here is the kickoff. It will be fielded by Rorick Lowe at the goal line to the 10. And to the 11, where the tackle is made by Tim Shannon. Conjecture all week whether or not Reggie Ogburn will play. He will not start. It'll be Kevin Lusk. Lusk is a sophomore from Seattle, Washington. Ogburn is in uniform. He is expected to see some action today. He's an outstanding option quarterback. Lusk basically is a drop-back passer. The running backs are Terrence Jones and Reggie Brown. And it is Reggie Brown, and he gets up to a bopping 13. Hit by Chip Banks. Linebackers for the Trojans, Byron Darby, Steve Busick, Chip Banks, and Eric Scoggins from left to right. It'll be second down and about 7. This time Reggie Brown gets the call again, and he goes to the 16.
The area that Reggie Ogden is not going to be playing for the Ducks, and so Kevin Lusk is going. So they're going to a power eye offense and not the multi-offense they usually run.
But he may cross them up. He does. It's to Reggie Brown, and he gets just 1 yard. Tackled by George Achika, the nose guard of the Trojans. Snapping the ball for Oregon is Scott Sutherland. He's a defensive tackle, but he also is the long snapper for the Ducks. Punt by Babb. That wind kind of holds it up there, and it hits it about the 48 and goes out of bounds around the 48-yard line of the Oregon Ducks. So now the Trojans are in great field position with a first down at the Oregon 48 as that punt went only 30 yards. In for the Trojans at the Oregon 48 as Rockshani moves out. Gordon Adams gives off to Marcus Allen, and he slams down to the 44. A pickup of 4 by the USC tailback, tackled by Mike Walter. Walter is a defensive end as Rich Brooks has made wholesale changes with his starting lineup for the Oregon Ducks in offense and defense. Number 47 is the man who calls the defensive signals for the Oregon Ducks, the middle linebacker, Ed Haggerty. Second and 6 at the 44 of Oregon. Looks like Jeff Simmons is almost lining up offside. It's Marcus Allen again. He's in the open, and he goes down at the 29-yard line.
What they're doing is the Ducks are running a flex defense, but the Trojans just got real good blocking here, and Marcus makes a great run. One thing you're going to notice real quick is the Ducks are not as high as I thought they would be for this game. It could be because of the key injuries to their ball players.
Oregon lost to Cal last week in Berkeley, 31-6. And they played with little intensity at Berkeley, and they were expected to have an all-out effort. Oh, the fumble, and it's picked off in midair. It's grabbed by Gibbs, Ross Gibbs. And Gibbs brings it out to the 47-yard line of the Oregon Ducks. Ross Gibbs, a cornerback, number 6, from Bourbon Day High School in Los Angeles. And it was Gibbs who was tackled by Keith Van Horn, a Trojan offensive tackle.
Mike, we just commented about the Trojans are having the impetus here, and they just gave the other team the chance to get back in the ball game. Here Gibbs gets the fumble in midair, and Keith Van Horn makes the tackle.
We have played about 3.5 minutes in this first quarter from Autzen Stadium in Eugene. Lusk on the pitch. It's the Red Brown. Brown is hit by Dennis Smith. Second and 3. As you look at Kevin Lusk, the Oregon quarterback, the ball at the Trojan 46. No score. First quarter. Mike Walden along with Mike Garrett. Reggie Brown gets the call again, gets 1 yard, stopped at the 45. Dennis Edwards in your picture, number 7. Now they go into the old-fashioned T formation, a full house backfield for Oregon. Lusk on the option. And the Trojans weren't fooled, but he might have been able to pick up the first down. He needed just 2 yards, and I think Lusk got that 2 yards. It depends on where the ball is spotted. Eric Scoggins on the tackle. So they got it by about half the length of the football. First down, Oregon at the Trojan 43. Mosier wide to the left side, along with Kurt Jackson. So far, Lusk hasn't attempted a pass. The pitch to Reggie Brown. He slips one tackle. Busick had a shot at him. And finally, he's forced out of bounds at the 41. Oregon with a record of 2-2-1 overall, 1-2 in the Pac-10. Trojans, of course, 5-0, 2-0 in the league. It's Reggie Brown again.
Mike, the Ducks are not doing anything fancy. They just went straight at the Trojans, running man-on-man blocking, and just hopefully they can get the opening, and they believe in Reggie Brown can really run the ball, and so far he has done that.
Remember this about Rich Brooks, the Oregon coach. He used to be the special teams coach with the San Francisco 49ers.
That's right.
Then an assistant with the Rams, twice an assistant at UCLA, handled the special teams at UCLA. So a lot of the SC players thought maybe they would see some good. Lusk on the option, trying to pick up the first down, and I don't know if he got it or not. 9:22 to play in the first period. No score between Oregon and USC. University of Nevada, Las Vegas. This will be the Oregon homecoming game next week. First down, Oregon again. Lusk has Terrence Jones and Dwight Robertson as his running backs now. It's Dwight Robertson, and he's stopped right about the line of scrimmage by Dennis Edwards, Jr. from Edison High School in Stockton. Second down, 9, Oregon at the Southern California 31. Lusk hands off to Reggie Brown, and he's nailed right at the line of scrimmage, the 31-yard line. A good hit put on Reggie Brown by George Achika. Lusk has Mosier and Jackson wide to the left side. Lusk looking for either Mosier or Jackson, and down he goes! Lusk is nailed and sacked by Byron Darby on the sack.
No question. And then Usher gave him the inside pursuit and Darby the outside, and they make a great play, and it puts the Ducks in bad field position.
By the way, the field goal kicker for Oregon, Pat English, is injured, and he won't kick today. So their kicking will be handled by Jollymore from Claremont, California, senior. Babb aiming for the sideline boundaries, and... kicks it out of bounds at the 15-yard line. We have 7:09 to go in the first quarter. No score between Oregon and the Trojans of USC. By the way, Paul DeLulo is here. May see some action today. Paul's father died about a week ago. Just rejoined the club today. Adams pitches back to Marcus Allen, 15. Marcus Allen across the 20, up to the 22. Tackled by Vince Goldsmith. Down and two. The ball is at the 22. I don't think he weighed 249, however. Adams on a swing pass. Marcus Allen too much. Third down and two at the 22. The pitch to Allen juggles. Allen across the 25 to about the 27. Remember, USC has a 25-game unbeaten streak on the line here today in Eugene. That's the second longest in the nation, the second longest in USC history. First and 10 at the 27 of the Trojans. Here comes Rakshani. It's Allen again to the 30. Makes his cut at the 35. 40. Down he goes at the 43. Rips off a gain of 16 yards. Brought down by the strong safety, Joe Figures.
I'm glad Marcus Allen is not suffering from the cold like we are up here, Mike. Here he makes a good play. He's looking downfield. Makes a very good move here. Cuts back across the grain and makes the good yards.
Already, Marcus Allen has rushed for 48 yards, 5 carries, and we still have 5:45 to play in the first quarter. Anthony Gibson is now the new tailback as Allen will get a breather. Adams to throw, completes it to Jeff Simmons at the 47, and Jeff Simmons is bulldogged out of bounds by Oregon's cornerback, Ross Gibbs.
As SC's running game takes hold of a game, then it makes the offensive pass game so easy. And Jeff Simmons has one-on-one with Gibbs, and Gibbs just cannot cover him and makes the tackle.
It'll be second down and a yard to go for the first down for the Trojans at the Oregon 47. Fullback McKenzie, who gets the first down. Simmons is wide to the left side. Rakshani wide to the right side. Now Rakshani in motion. It's Marcus Allen. 40, 35, 30. Allen. Allen still on his feet. Penalty marker goes down, and so does Allen at the 20-yard line of the Oregon Ducks. The tackle was made by Joe Figures, Mike Walter, and Mike Nolan.
Typical SC power play where Marcus seizes the power and he just jumps outside and goes and makes a very good carry here.
It'll be holding against Southern California. So far, the Trojans have been their own worst enemies here in this first quarter. 4.5 minutes left in the first period. Rakshani and Simmons wide to the right shot. Wide to the right side as Adams pitches back to Allen. Marcus makes his turn and he's nailed by Joe Figures. Good tackle by number 40. Joe Figures, the strong safety, a junior from Sacramento, and he is the leading tackler for the Oregon Ducks.
Yes. What happened was that the tight end did not block down, so that releases the strong safety, then he can get pursued, and what he did was get penetration and stop the play. And Joe Figures has been doing that all year, Mike.
No score here at Autzen Stadium in Eugene. The Trojans have been moving, but they have been hurt by fumbles and penalties. Simmons wide to the right side. Second and 26. In motion goes Allen. Adams looking, throwing, and he completes it to Kevin Wood. Oh, he dropped it out of bounds.
Here Adams is looking at Kevin. Kevin's been a one-on-one coverage. You can't do that with Kevin. Now when he steps, he's stepping on the line, so that's considered out of bounds.
Right in front of the Oregon back. Kevin Williams lined up as the tailback. Now he moves up as the split end. Penalty marker dropped. Adams just cradles the ball.
5 yards, delay of game.
And you are now 2-for-2. Third and 31 now as the ball goes back to the 41-yard line of SC. Adams has time. Incomplete to the fullback, McKenzie. Here they had the rush on. Play almost had it blocked. A good punt by Pryor, aided and abetted by the wind, and the ball rolls, and down quickly for the Trojans trying to get that ball was Marvin Williams. We have 3:14 to play in the first quarter. The Oregon 20. Luskett quarterback. The pitch goes to Reggie Brown on the left side, and Brown gets maybe a yard or two. The USC down through the years has featured bigger defensive units, but I doubt if they featured any quicker than this 1980 edition. Here comes Reggie Brown again. Got some good running room, but a penalty marker is dropped at the 21.
Holding against the Ducks.
It's against Oregon, all right. So now it'll be second down and 20 at the 10-yard line. Rich Brooks, who last year was the Pac-10 Coach of the Year. Second and 20 at the 10. Reggie Brown again, and we have less than 2 minutes to go in the first quarter.
So far in this game, the Trojans are controlling the line of scrimmage on offense and defense.
Greg Mosier and Kurt Jackson are wide to the right side as the Trojans anticipate a Kevin Lusk pass right here. He's going to cross them up, and instead it's going to be the tailback Reggie Brown, and Brown is hit at the 12-yard line by Charles Ussery. A loss of a yard on the play. Timmy White and Jeff Fisher deep for Southern California. The Trojans should take this ball right around midfield or maybe the Oregon 40. Good snap from the center, Sutherland. Line drive, type kick. Fisher at the 47, 45. Fisher at the 40, fumbles the ball. The Oregon Ducks come up with the ball. We have 50 seconds till the end of this first quarter. No score from Eugene. All right, a big cheer from the Oregon crowd as Reggie Ogburn comes in at quarterback for the first time today from the Oregon 40. He's an option specialist, and he gives to the fullback, Terrence Jones. A gain of 3 by Jones, tackle made by Chip Banks.
Mike, this is a key substitute. The Oregon Ducks are looking at the SC play, and they're saying, SC, they just want to give us the game. So why don't we put our good people in, and maybe they'll play well. And maybe we can get a score, and then I'll put more pressure on the Trojans.
John Robinson pacing up and down in front of the Trojan bench must be saying to himself, my goodness, I can't believe my own eyes.
He says, this is homecoming, and they're treating me like this.
Second down and 7 at the 43. Ogburn on the option, pitches back. Here is Brown trying to hold on to it, and a big pile up at about the 32, and I think the Trojans have the ball.
I think Ogburn recovered for the Oregon Ducks.
It looked like Dennis Smith was in there, but such a big pileup you couldn't.
It squirted out of Dennis Smith's arms, and Ogden made the recovery. Here's the toss here to his tailback, Reggie Brown. Reggie cannot get the handle on it. Get a break on their behalf, and Ogburn makes the good recovery.
Dwight Robertson and Jones are the running backs for Reggie Ogburn. It's third and about 20 at the 32. Ogburn on the option is cut down at the 33-yard line. Good sharp tackle by the Rover back, Ronnie Lott.
What they're trying to do now is use Ogburn to keep the defense really wide open. Then he can go to the openings and make great moves, and he has great speed. He runs a 4.5 40.
Reggie Ogburn, O-G-B-U-R-N, out of Miami, Florida, senior. Trouble with muscle spasms in his back. Spent the week in traction. Only worked out late Thursday afternoon with the club. Mike Babb ready to punt again, but he'll have the wind at his back this time, so he's just booming out of there. It will be Timmy White at the 29. White retreats, and the Ducks pour in on him and push him back all the way to the 22. They will their own 25. Brock Shawnee moving out. It's Marcus Allen.
Second down, 7 for the Trojans, runner 28.
Dennis Clay was the injured Oregon player. He's off the field under his own power. Here comes Marcus Allen. Picked up at the 31 by Mike Burkett. A lot of time left in the second quarter. Over 13 minutes to go before halftime. Adams to throw. Off to Marcus Allen. Marcus gets to the 35, but he may have stepped out of bounds at the 33. And yes, that's the ruling by the head linesman, Ray Heisman. Eugene Choo Choo Young is the deep man for Oregon, standing on his own 26. Good snap from the center, Bruce Matthews. Fair catch signal four by Choo Choo Young at the 33. First and 10 at the 33. Ogborn throws it out over to Mark James. He's got some running room. And now the quick Trojan defense closes in on him and drops him at the 28.
Second and 5 is a great way to be.
Ball is at the 38 of Oregon. Ogburn slips one tackle, but there is Busick grabbing him around the shoulder pads and just pulling him down to the AstroTurf.
With Ogburn in there, does one great thing. It makes a lot of people miss and discourages your defense, and he runs your defense to death. So if the Trojans don't get that defensive team off the field pretty soon, they could be in trouble.
They need a long one for the first down. Ogburn on the option. Down he goes as he's hit by Ronnie Lott, and another penalty marker down. Holding against the Oregon Ducks. And I don't know if our cameras picked it up, but Ogburn just went over and shook hands with Lott as if to say, good hit. There's the walk-off against Oregon, and the ball now goes back to the 28-yard line. You would have to say this hasn't been one of the more spectacular games that we have seen so far this year. It'll be third down and 16 for Oregon with the ball back at the Ducks 28. Here's Ogburn, and he's nailed by Byron Darby.
When in doubt on defense, you get penetration, you stop any offensive play going. Byron Darby gets penetration on this mic, and Ogburn can't do anything.
Timmy White, Jeff Fisher, deep for the Trojans. Good snap from Sutherland, and a good punt by Babb. Timmy White at the 32, back to the 35, 40. White is hit hard at the 41-yard line. We have 10 and a half minutes to play in the second quarter. Trojans with a first down at the 40-yard line.
Mike, this is the best field position the Trojans had in this game so far.
No. They were at the 48-yard line of Oregon. See, now they're at the SC 40, and there's a gain of about 3 or 4 yards, hit by Mike Walter. Shawnee to the left side. Mackenzie Allen out of the I formation of USC. Adams fakes. He's throwing across the middle to Marcus Allen. And Allen is pulled down at the 47.
Quite often, the quarterback wants to look for his tight end. He doesn't see him. And the halfback will break open when he goes down. And this is happening with Allen. He hit Allen. And Marcus tried to get the 2 yards, but he's a little shy now. Look, he's shy 4 yards.
Marcus Allen is averaging better than 157 yards per game.
That's a lot of work.
He also is the leading pass receiver for Southern California. Adams throwing this time to Jeff Simmons at the 43 of Oregon. Tackled by Steve Brown, the cornerback. Good grab by the sophomore from Edison High School in Stockton, Jeff Simmons.
Jeff Simmons just improves game after game, and here he looks like a ballerina. I mean, or a ballet artist, whatever you want to call him. He makes the play and watch him. The foot's underneath, but he relaxes so he doesn't pull him up. He hears I call him a ballerina.
Rakshani moving out. It's the fullback, McKenzie. And McKenzie goes to the 38. 8.5 minutes to go before halftime. On a sunshiny Saturday afternoon from Eugene, Oregon. Oregon SC, no score. Second and five at the Oregon 38. Booing because they felt that Simmons was beyond the end line and the pass play should be nullified.
Mike, they're really wrong because they should look at his feet. And if you have 1 foot in bounds, it's good. And Jeff had two.
Boy, is he happy over there. Look at it. Out of the hold of Scott Tinsley. Eric Kipp trying to kick the extra point. It's good. What it's all about, do you?
Can't blame it on us. It's not a TV timeout.
No way.
Fans are not a request. The officials, please, for the safety of the players, to please refrain from throwing ice on the
plane. Ah, there it is.
Thank you.
Some of the fans upset. They thought that Simmons was beyond the end line and out of the field of play when he made that sensational grab, and some people were throwing ice from the stands. That held up the play. Hip angles the ball over the sidelines to Lowe at the five. Fumbles the ball up to the 10, and now he's out of bounds around the line.
And they got one with Jeff Simmons. Here, Lowe just fumbles the ball here, and Marvin does a great job and makes the play. Marvin Williams is one of the key people on the specialty team.
Quarterback, Reggie Ogborn. He pitches back to Brown. Out of bounds near the 15.
The outside, they tied him in a great block on Darby, so they may try and do that again.
Second and seven from the Oregon 13. Jones, the fullback. He's to the 16. Here's number 80, and he has great hands. Third and five. The pitch goes to the tailback, Reggie Brown. Brown gets up to about the 19. Reggie Ogburn looking over that Trojan defense. He wants to throw, and he... No good! He was throwing to John Brosterhouse, his flanker back. The pass a little...
Ronnie Lott had that play totally timed. He was watching Ogburn just set up. He just lopped, stayed off a little bit. When the ball came, he came in, made the great time play, and just simply missed it.
And did you notice that Byron Darby unloaded on Ogburn as he unloaded the pass? Second and 10, Oregon. Ogburn throws again, and again, it's almost intercepted.
If you're a receiver, this is one thing you don't want to be. In midair, the ball's coming, and had the defenders coming in and crush you. And Kirk Jackson didn't want any part of that ball.
7-0, USC over Oregon. Here comes Brosterhouse, the flanker back in motion. Ogburn throws to Brosterhouse. And he goes to the 20-yard line. Brought down by Eric Scoggin. Dropping back deep as we look at the SC head coach, John Robinson, who played football for Lynn Casanova here in Eugene and then later was an assistant coach for some 4 years on the Oregon staff. 6 minutes, still halftime. 7-0, the Trojans lead. Babb gets off a beautiful punt. At the 35-yard line is Timmy White. White looking, retreating. Now he's got, oh, he had a great path, and he slips and falls at the 39-yard line.
Timmy White had a pick to the right where he caught the ball, and all he has to do is run to the sidelines as fast as he can. And there he just slips and falls, and if he stayed up on his feet, he may have gone all the way.
Rich Brooks over in the sidelines is really upset, and... The crowd reacting to Rich Brooks upset with the officials about something.
He thought he was clipped.
First and 10. The ball is at the 37.
So hold it here.
Look at Brooks really giving it to him. Marcus Allen to the 41. Mike Berkich and Ross Gibbs on the tackle for Oregon. Look at Rich is really hot, isn't he? He's steaming.
This game is a game of inches, and you just want to take everything you can. And when the referee doesn't help you out, particularly when you think it's a bad call, you can really get furious.
It's the back judge, John Barger, who's taking the brunt of the verbal attack from Rich Brooks. And off to Marcus Adam. Big pass, 50, down to the 45. And a penalty marker goes down at the 47-yard.
From a lot of flags, and... It's unbelievable. This is against the Trojans, and I think they're evening out, so both teams can really pitch a lot of complaints. But it's always terrible when referees or umpires take the game away from the ball player.
I would appreciate it if the referee would turn around and give us the signal. He turns around to the press box at the north side, but we're on the south side.
I think he called it holding.
Yeah, he did. I picked it up the second time, but it would help if he would turn
first
around
and for the
for both sides.
I like to see his face, too.
And he's supposed to do that. First down for the Trojans. The ball is at the 48 of Southern California. Adams to throw for Kevin Williams. Intercepted. Brown has it. Steve Brown. Brown brings it back to the 42-yard line of Southern California. Steve Brown, a sophomore from Sacramento, with his second interception this season for the Oregon.
That's right. And it was a one-on-one coverage, so the cornerback can really just sit in there, or the safety in this play, and he just waited until the ball came and just made the crucial step in and got the ball from Kevin and makes a great play for the Ducks.
In motion goes Kurt Jackson. Oregon with great field position now at the 41 of the Trojans. Pitch back to Reggie Brown. And Reggie Brown is crunched down by Chip.
Watch out, because the defense offensive line for the Ducks will hurt you.
Reggie Brown goes to the 35, hit hard by the inside linebacker,
Reggie
Chip
Banks.
For Oregon at the 35 of Southern California. Quarterback sneak, Reggie Ogburn is hit after he picked up just 2 yards. Chip Banks again, so a
he forgot that Chip Banks was still in the middle and got stuck very hard.
It's going to be fourth and about a yard and a half as Oregon lines up in a power eye right formation. The running backs will be Terrence Jones, 33, Ladera Johnson, number 9, a timeout called by Oregon as Reggie Ogburn wants to talk things over with head coach Rick. They do not. They go to the old-fashioned T full house backfield. Jones is the fullback, 33 in the middle. Ogburn carries on the option. First down, Oregon.
Mike, on the last timeout, SC called that timeout, not the Oregon Ducks. And what they do is switch over from a 3-4 defense to an 8-man line, hopefully to stop that progress. And Ogden, what he does so well is that he faked it, got the hole, and just took it and got the crucial yards. Good play.
Great faking ability by Oregon senior quarterback Reggie Ogburn from Miami, Florida. First and 10 at the Trojan 28-yard line. Joey Browner made the tackle on Ogburn. But now the Ducks down there knocking at the SC door. Trojan 7, Oregon nothing. 2.5 minutes till halftime. Ogburn fakes, throws into the end zone. Now for Oregon on 2nd and 10 at the Trojan 28. On the option, Ogburn flips it back. That's Reggie Brown out of bounds at the Trojan 5-yard line.
Brown out of bounds at the USC 6. First and goal.
That was pure vintage Reggie Ogburn on the option play.
This is Reggie Ogburn at his best. Just watch a magician work. He gives it to his best ball carrier, Reggie Brown. He gets tackled by Ronnie Lott in about the 6-yard line.
Lott may have saved an SC touchdown right there.
No question about that, Mike. Great play.
First and goal to go. Or rather, saved a touchdown for the Trojans. It's first and goal to go for Oregon at the Southern California 5. 7-0. SC leads. The pitch goes to Reggie Brown. 5-yard line. Touchdown, Oregon.
He fumbled the ball before he went in. Be interesting to see how the referees call it.
But the head linesman, Ray Highsmith, signaled touchdown as he went across.
He called it prematurely.
Well, they're going to debate it right now. Number 44 is Highsmith, the head linesman, and his arms went up in the air as Reggie Brown crossed the goal line.
He went across the goal line without the ball, however.
Now, the big dispute is it a touchdown or not? The fumble was picked off in midair by Joey Browner, the cornerback.
I would hate to be the referee who made that signal at this point.
And if it goes against Oregon, look out.
And if I lived in Oregon and I was a referee, look out.
Number 22 is the referee, Don Hable, and he's conferring with his officials. But the Trojans say, yes, SC claims it was a fumble in midair. The touchdown is taken away. Look at Rich Brooks now. The Trojans have the ball.
Mike, we're going to see probably the play of the year. Ogden makes an opposite rotation to where the play's going. Reggie Brown is going to look like he's going to score here. There's the fumble.
The ball, he was hit at the 2-yard line.
That's right.
And the blame belongs in this case with the officials.
No question.
The headlinesman, Highsmith, went up in the air with both hands signaling touchdown. But the hit was made at the two-yard line, and they're trying to explain that now to Rich Brooks, the Oregon coach.
The referee anticipated, even though the ball carrier would get hit, that he would go in the end zone regardless. He just didn't take into consideration that the ball carrier would fumble, and that's what happened.
I'm trying to determine who made the tackle of Reggie Brown at about the two-yard line. It could be Chip Banks. It looked like 51. It was difficult to tell on the replay.
It was inside out position, so it most likely was a linebacker.
Whatever the explanation is, Rich Brooks appears to be pacified. I'm sure inside he is boiling. But at least the explanation satisfies him at this point.
So far, that's 14 points has gone against him, where Simmons made a great catch, gave it to SC, and now his team supposedly scored, and now they take the touchdown from him again.
Now the crowd, of course, booing here in Eugene, Oregon, but if they could see, if they had the benefit of the replay, as we do, and by the way, congratulations to our cameraman, excellent camera work on that play. If they had benefit of that replay, then I'm sure they would see where the ball flipped up in the air as Banks made the hit on Reggie Brown at the two-yard line. But one of the officials, and it was Ray Highsmith, the head linesman, went up in the air with both hands, signaling touchdown.
Just shows you cannot anticipate any kind of call.
Now the Trojans will have the ball, first and 10, from their own one-yard line. Rakshani in motion, a quarterback sneak by Gordon Adams. He moves it out to the four-yard line. Oh, listen to this crowd now. Second down at about 8 for the Trojans. It's Marcus Allen, stopped at the 5. Oregon is really fired up now, and Haggerty signaling for an Oregon timeout. 55 till halftime. USC 7-0 over Oregon. And the boos increase as Gordon Adams and the Trojans come out over the ball, led by center Alan Pugh. It's Marcus Allen sweeping to the right to the 10-yard line. He is up to the 12-yard line, and that'll be enough for a first down for Southern California. It's Marcus Allen to the 15, to the 20, up to the 21. We have less than a minute to go in the first half, 7-0 USC. It is Marcus Allen into the middle, up to the 27. First and 10 Trojans at the 27. Rakshani in motion. The pitch to Allen. He just had to struggle to get back to the line of scrimmage. Tackled by Joe Figgers, a strong safety. The first half, and another chorus of boos greet the Trojans as they go off the field. 7-0 up over the Oregon Ducks. To number 48, Reggie Brown. Now, Brown is about the 10-yard line right here. Now he makes his cut at the 5-yard line. He is not in. He is tackled by Chip Banks. The ball goes behind him, hits the AstroTurf, and is recovered by Joey Browner at the 2-yard line. However, the head linesman, Ray Highsmith, signaled touchdown Oregon. Highsmith did not see Brown into the end zone with the football. He did not see the fumble. And naturally, when one of the officials gives you a touchdown sign, the Oregon fans felt that he was in and had scored the touchdown, but he did not. SC took over, and SC leads at halftime 7-0. In the middle for the Trojans, and it's going to be grabbed off here by Jeff Brown, and Brown will return it to around the 33-yard line. Jeff Brown, a lineman, brought down by Clifford Gibson for Oregon. In the first half, the Trojans had 179 total yards to just 66 for Oregon. Marcus Allen has gained 84 yards in 15 carries, and Reggie Brown is the top ball carrier for Oregon, 19 for 52. Trojans have passed for 65 yards, 5 out of 9. Of course, the big play was Adams to Simmons for the 38-yard touchdown. Marcus Allen tries the middle. A second and 7 at the 36 as you look over the shoulder of Vince Goldsmith, the defensive tackle, looking in on the SC huddle. Marcus Allen, nothing there.
He took a hit on the shoulder or the head. Hingle gets penetration. Marcus is running like a fake delayed one way and coming back the other, and Hingle gets pursued. And you can see that he was hit behind, and so when he did hit Marcus, he was in a bad body position. So it probably just traumatized his body, Mike.
Hinkle, by the way, is a converted quarterback. That's the reason he has the low number, 16. Most always the linebackers are in the 50s
or the 60s. But
can you imagine a quarterback playing linebacker? Unheard of.
Hinkle felt that last tackle, that's for sure. Third down and seven at the 36. Well, it's closer to the 35. Here comes Kevin Williams. As Adams sets up the throw, he dumps it off to Allen, drops the ball at the 40-yard line.
So often Adams is going by looking for his tight end or his deep people and throwing to his tailback, and Marcus just does not catch it here. No excuse for that one.
Might have taken his eye off to look at Haggerty, the middle linebacker. And the deep man is Choo Choo Young for the Oregon Ducks, standing on his 18. Nice, beautiful, booming spiral. Young takes it at the 25. 30. Young goes down at the 30-yard line as penalty markers are dropped as well. Referee Don Hable giving the clipping signal against the Oregon Ducks.
Here we go. Here's the punt. Receiver has it. Right there, he hits Keith Browner. That is the penalty they just called.
And the quarterback is Kevin Lusk, who started the game today for Oregon. And then late in the first period, Reggie Ogburn came in and went the rest of the way. 7-0 USC over the Ducks. Lusk sets up a screen pass. It's batted down by Byron Darby and Charles Usley.
Last week, Chick Banks did the same thing and came up and made a great catch. Here, Byron Darby tips it, has the consciousness of where the ball is, but just can't get to the ball.
Lusk flips to the tailback, Reggie Brown, around the right side. And Reggie gets to the 17, put down by linebacker Chip Banks. Just a junior from Augusta, Georgia. Third and eight at the 17. Reggie Brown again to the 19, tackled by Charles Usery. Mike Babb will have to punt into this strong wind now from left to right, out of the west at about 20 miles an hour. So the Trojans should get this ball about midfield. Fisher and White are deep for Southern California. The boot by Babb, it'll be fielded by Jeff Fisher at the 48. He goes to the 50, to the 48 of Oregon, where he is tackled. 12:04 to play in the third quarter. USC 7, Oregon nothing. First and 10 now for USC. The ball is at the 48 of Oregon. It's Duck McKenzie, the fullback. Stopped at the 45.
That was a great hit inside. Where Haggerty and company just kind of fills up the gap here. And the fullback takes a shot. He doesn't carry the ball very often, but he takes a real good hit here. Good play.
John Robinson conferring with Paul Hackett in back of Robbie. Hudson Hauk, the offensive line coach. Second and 7, Trojans at the 45 of Oregon. Here comes Marcus Allen, 40, down close to the 35. Spilled at the 36 by linebacker Andy Vabora. Three tight ends for the Trojans. Marcus Allen with 94 yards and 18 carries. From the 36 of Oregon, Adams tosses it to Hobie Brenner. Cut down at the 32 by Gibbs, the cornerback. It'll be second down, 6 at the 32. Allen makes his cut at the 30, down to the 26 of Oregon. SC to the ball at the Oregon 26. Gordon Adams from Newport Harbor High, fifth-year senior at SC, gives to Allen, straight down the middle, crunched down at the 22. Jeff Simmons wide to the left side as Rakshani moves in motion, second and 6 at the Oregon 22. It's Allen again at the 20, out of bounds around the 18.
I think the Trojans are wearing him down.
Well, that Oregon defense has been on the field a lot.
Yes, they have.
And we have 9:18 to play in the third quarter.
That means right away they've been on the field maybe six minutes already.
USC 7, Oregon nothing. The pitch to Allen. Makes his cut at the 20. He goes to the 15 and a penalty marker down.
Most likely that defense, that the penalty is against the Trojans. And
holding
against USC.
I don't think that the fans must agree. They wouldn't much blame them.
Rakshani and Simmons are wide to the right side. Adams hands off to Allen. Allen getting his blocking set up. Down he goes at the 28. A gain of just 3 by Allen. Vince Goldsmith led the charge of the green-shirted Oregon hip.
The Trojans have done things very nicely for Hip all year. They keep giving him a right to a left hook on it, which is a natural hook for him.
Out of the hold of Scott Tinsley, it has the distance. It is no good. It is no good. Off to the right side. Eric This is a 45-yard field goal, but wait a minute. Another penalty marker has been dropped. Roy Foster looking on. It'll be against USC. Illegal procedure declined, of course, by the Oregon Ducks. Quarterback is Kevin Lusk. LUSK across the middle. Completes it to the tight end, Hoganson. Greg Hoganson right at the 30-yard line. And the pass play netted Oregon only 2 yards. Sets up to throw. Here they come, and down he goes at the 20. Robinson and the Trojans are seeing both here today. Third and 18 at the 20. They give us to Dwight Robertson. Breaks out to the 30. Robertson goes down at the 31-yard line. A pickup of 11. Jeff Fisher made the tackle.
Great play. Lusk makes a great decision. Goes with the draw, which has been very successful against the very fast-reacting Trojan defense. And he gives the ball to his best, one of his best carriers. We're Dwight Robertson makes a good play.
But Oregon is 8 yards shy of a first down, so now Mike Babb, who has been punting all day long, will be back to do his thing again. Fisher is the up man. Here they come, and here is the boot by Babb. Hangs it high. Fair catch signal four by Jeff Fisher at the 40. 6:03 to play third quarter. Touchdown of the game, a 38-yarder from Gordon Adams to Jeff Simmons. First and 10 Trojans. Adams got a run. It's a busted play, and Adams is hit at the 40-yard line. Tackle was made by Ross Gibbs.
Mike, if I was on defense and I was watching the offense play the way they're doing now, where a quarterback takes the snap and can't hold on, you know, I would hold my breath and say, they just got to give me a chance to rest. I just can't control this game like this.
Sophomore from Merced, Tony Slayton. Steps up, fires it to Allen. Oh, and is Allen hit in two at the 45. Wow, he was really cracked. The tackle was made by Dwight Ford. Great hit by Ford on Allen.
That's right. The quarterback goes back again, cannot find his man. So what he does so often, he looks for his tailback who just went through the line of scrimmage.
Look at that hit by Ford.
Yes, great hit.
Third and five at the 46 of USC. Trojan 7, Oregon nothing, 4:50 left in this third quarter. Mike Walden and Mike Garrett from Eugene. Adams across the middle to Allen. He fumbles the ball. They rule it an incomplete forward pass. But the Oregon fans have felt they've been cheated all day, and that just adds fuel to the fire.
It's unbelievable. Here the plays to Allen. Now make your own judgment here if he had control of it. The ball slipping out before he got hit, so be a tough one to call that he had actual control.
This one is kind of shanked off the side of his foot. Takes an SC roll, is picked up by Choo Choo Young. He's up to the 20-yard line, and down he goes. We have 4:25 left in the third quarter. There was a penalty on that punt by Pryor, so now he's going to have to kick it from about his own 20. A holding penalty against the Trojans, their third holding penalty of the day. This backs Choo Choo Young all the way to the 16, and he says, hey, fair catch. Choo Choo is only 5'8", and he weighs, oh, soaking wet, I guess, about 160. He's from Northern California, the smallest man on the Oregon roster, hence the nickname Choo Choo.
Choo Choo.
Either that or stretch. One of the two. This is Reggie Brown around the right side. Reggie Brown moves it up to the 22. I thought Oregon would come out and use some trick plays, some gimmicks, but so far, basically the standard stuff. Reggie Brown goes to the 24.
It doesn't matter which quarterback they have. May it be Ogburn or Lusk.
Reggie Brown.
It's either one will be pitching to the tailback, Reggie Brown, and it's not much deception or innovation at all.
Of course, from Oregon's standpoint, when you've got your number one quarterback and he really has only worked one day in practice, it's difficult to try any trick plays. You've got to spend time and a lot of time those plays to perfect them.
You're right.
Here comes Lusk. He's ready to throw, and he's got a man open. Moser, 45, 50. Here comes Ronnie Lott after Moser, and Lott will run him down at the 10-yard line. A penalty marker on the play.
The referee is standing back like it's against the Oregon Ducks, but I hate to pinch your ass because I'm always wrong.
It's against USC.
63-yard pass play. Kevin Lusk to Greg Mosier, and only the speed of Ronnie Lott prevents an Oregon touchdown.
Mosier was covered, but the defender failed, so Mosier had clear field, and Ronnie Lott, being a 4-5 sprinter, ran him down about the 15-yard line, and he saves the Trojans from being scored upon.
And USC calls for a timeout, as Oregon has it first and goal at the USC 9.5. Now it's up to the USC defense. Oregon with a first and goal, the ball at the 9.5 of SC. It is down to the 3. Terrence Jones, the fullback. Tackle made by Chip Banks.
Nothing fancy here, just running straight at people. It's like a cross block at the nose of the center. Great run.
The ball is near the 3-yard line of SC. A power eye formation for Oregon. The pitch to Reggie Brown. He is stopped at about the line of scrimmage by George Achika, SC's sophomore nose guard from San Jose. Tim Tyler and Hoganson, two tight ends for Oregon, full house backfield. Johnson is the left half. Jones is the fullback. Brown is the right half. It is Jones into the middle. Touchdown, Oregon! Sidelines. The sophomore fullback from Sacramento gets in from 3 yards out.
They double team the nose man, Byron Darby, here, and Terrence Jones just goes over for a big touchdown. And you can't say anything else, but the Ducks may have the great game under control at this point.
You can add this. This Oregon touchdown holds up. And now here's the try for extra point. It's good. We have a tie game from Upson Stadium in Eugene. 1:24 to go, third quarter. It is tied at 7. Here in Eugene, Oregon, on their feet, applauding the Oregon Ducks as they have tied the number 2 ranked team, USC, at 7. It will be Marv Williams at the 4, 10, 15. Williams to the 20, to the outside, 30, 35. And he's rolled out of bounds at the 36-yard line.
Last week, when the Trojans were in question if they're going to take control of the game, they got the ensuing kickoff and ran it back like Marvin Williams is doing here, where he does a great job here.
First and 10 at the Trojan 36. Pugh is back in there at center. The pitch to Allen. And he has to struggle to get to the line of scrimmage. Marcus Allen, 23 carries, 110 yards. So Marcus has been over the century mark in every SC game this year. Adams to throw, has time, now he doesn't. Dwight Ford, sacks Gordon Adams back at the 26.
If there's any question of the Oregon Ducks are up for this game at this point, look at Dwight Ford, number 57, come in penetration and make the good play on Gordon Adams. Trojans are in bad field position at this time.
Did you notice how Adams was trying to protect that ball, too, to make sure that he did not fumble? Second, or rather third down and 20, third and 20 at the 26. Now the chant goes up, beat SC. This will be the final play of the third quarter. Adams has time. Incomplete. Throwing for Timmy White at the 40. 7-7. Here is the first play of the fourth quarter as Pryor prepares to punt to Choo Choo Young. Good snap from Linebach and a good punt by Pryor. Choo Choo's back all the way up to the 25. He's in trouble. Down he goes at the 27. On defense, Dennis Edwards, George Achika, Charles Essery, Byron Darby, Steve Busick, Chip Banks, Eric Scoggins, Jeff Fisher, Joey Browner, Ronnie Lott, and Dennis Smith.
From the Oregon 27, the pitch is to Reggie Brown, and Brown gets maybe one, but no more.
They only have one man in the backfield.
Lust to throw, pumps once, second time, complete the Mosier at the 40, up to the 43, tackled by Steve Busey. And the combination of Lust to Mosier works once again. First down, Oregon at the Ducks 43.
The Ducks went to a passing offense where they have only one man back, and Lust, who does not roll out that well in throw, does a great job. But Mosier turning in on like a 15 or 18 yard turn in, which is very, very bread and butter offensive passing down or play.
Gain of 15 and a first down for Oregon from their own 43. The game tied early in the fourth quarter. Here's Reggie Brown. Brown to the 47. One thing about Greg Mosier.
When you want a great defense, you want a defense that comes at you, but just not one person, but a swarm of people.
Greg Mosier,
the Trojans did,
has such great hands that Rich Brooks entrusts him with as the holder for PATs and field goal attempts. He's also an outfielder and a shortstop on the Oregon baseball team.
He runs very clever patterns too, Michael.
Second and six at the 47. Brown once again. Reggie Brown up close to the 50. Tackled by Byron Darby.
They'll go to the tight end, which they haven't done too much today.
The tight end is Hoganson. Greg Hoganson, number 88. 12 and a half minutes left, a 7-7 tie. It's Terrence Jones, the fullback, trying to pick up the first down. He gets it to the 49 of SC, a gain of just one. Byron Darby on the tackle.
Michael, I don't understand that move at all. Of course, I'm not Coach Brooks, and they don't pay me to do this for a living. But I thought they would go to the tight end and try and open up, because when they went with one man in the backfield and went that in the second down, I used surely they would do it in third and three, but they didn't.
Right back, ready to punt. He has the wind at his back. Timmy White, Fisher, deep for the Trojans. Aiming for the sidelines. Fair catch signal four by Timmy White at the 13. And White
calls a fair catch at the USC 13.
Mike, this is nervous time.
First down at the USC 13. Rakshani moves out. It's Marcus Allen into the middle. Just 1 yard. Second and eight at the Trojan 15. Slayton is in there at center now. Crowd here in Eugene trying to get behind the Ducks defense. Marcus Allen, first down and then some. Allen still on his feet as he goes up to the 29.
2 plays ago, they tried this, and Goldsmith and Sutherland stopped him. They came right back on a crucial down, which means their guards have a lot of confidence, and Marcus runs tough, gets the first down.
122 yards today for Marcus Allen. The USC, 28. Long count by Adams. Pass is caught by Jeff Simmons. Simmons making the grab at the 38.
38-yard line.
Steve Brown, the cornerback, on the tackle.
Jeff Simmons has been affected the last couple of games in particular. Here he makes a great reception here. Make sure he gets the feet in. Great completion.
It's Allen. And he scoots up to the 42. Allen picks up four. First down, Trojans. Vince Goldsmith put him down.
If you're wondering why the Trojans are designed to go in the middle, it's very obvious. They're running a flex defense, and they're actually trying to keep the Trojans inside their two tackles.
McKenzie is the fullback. Marcus Allen, the tailback. It's McKenzie. McKenzie up close to midfield as Doug McKenzie from Santa Barbara, a junior. Tackled by Joe Figures, the strong safety of the Ducks. 9:40 left, second and four. Nothing fancy. Here comes Marcus Allen again, and he slams down to the 41.
Every time you get nervous time for the Trojans, they seem to play best. And the linemen blow out, and Marcus runs like he can.
Linemen, of course, are Don Mosbar and Keith Van Horn at the tackles. Bruce Matthews and Roy Foster at the guards. And Tony Slayton now in there at center. Here comes Allen again at the 40. Slants down to about the 38. Put down by Andy Babora. Crowd getting restless here at Oregon because this has been a long, time-consuming drive by SC. Simmons is wide to the left side. Adams hands off to Allen. Nailed at the 40-yard line. Brian
Hinkle, the outside linebacker, right there with Allen to drop him at the 40, a loss of two.
Great play. If I was on defense, I would do the same thing. They're running at you. They're doing a good job. I've had my linebacker blitz in. Hinkle did that, made the good tackle.
Simmons and Timmy White to the right side. Does he go to Simmons? Or does he check off and go to a tight end? Or dump it off to the fullback? Allen coming out of the backfield. Adams will throw it to Allen at the 35. Allen down to the 32. Gain of about eight. And he's looking over in the direction of John Robinson. It'll be fourth and a yard to go for the first down. The ball is at the 32 of Oregon. And now the Trojans will use three tight ends. But first we're going to get an Oregon timeout. This drive started back at the SC 13. The Trojans have had it for 11 straight plays. Fourth and one at the Oregon 32. Will it be Allen? Will it be a quarterback sneak? It is Allen. He didn't make it. Marcus Allen stopped right at the line of scrimmage, the 32. Ed Haggerty in there, along with Andy Vibora.
Trojans have been very successful in the middle. They came at it one time too often, if you ask the Ducks, and they said, we're ready for you, and they make a great play. I think you're right. And I saw something very interesting on the sidelines, Mike. Chip Banks was kind of playing like on his right ankle, like he possibly is injured or is hampered by his leg.
Kevin Lusk at quarterback. Oregon takes over with the first down of the Ducks, 32. Lusk throws it to Reggie Brown, and a necktie tackle by Steve Busick.
To Reggie Brown, who's a great runner, and Steve Busick says, hey, I want you, even your head.
Second down, seven at the Oregon 35. That tells the whole story right there. The pitch to Reggie Brown. He's up to the 38. Third down and four at the Oregon 38. Oregon's got to do something here or punt. 6:35 to go. Lusk rolling out. Going to Mosier, who makes the grab at the 47. Right in front of Jeff Fisher. Mosier. And when Lusk and the Oregon Ducks are in trouble, they go to number 80, Greg Mosier, a sophomore from Hood River.
That's right. Fisher has Mosier one-on-one. Mosier just forces him back, then turns up. Fisher reacts very well, but just not in time.
And now Reggie Ogburn is in at quarterback for Oregon. Lusk, who was doing so well, goes out. Ogburn is back in. First down, Oregon at the Oregon 46. 6:15 to go. Give to Reggie Brown, straight ahead, pulled down by Chip Banks. I wonder how Kevin Lusk feels about being pulled in favor of Ogburn.
I would be very upset, particularly if I was very effective. And I know what the coaches are saying. Lusk is very good, and he's doing a good job. But just think if we had Reggie in there, Reggie even do more, and I think that's the reason.
The feeling could be that Lusk is a one-dimensional quarterback, whereas Ogburn is a three-dimensional threat.
I agree.
Jones carries to SC territory, the SC 48. And Lusk is back in at quarterback now for Oregon. It's third down and three at the SC 47. Kurt Jackson moving out, number 24. Lusk looking, fires it to Reggie Brown. Dennis Edwards misses him, and Brown gets to the 48. The tackle finally made by Tim Sullivan and Chip Banks.
Okay, what do you want to do against a defense that reacts well? You want to run draws or screens, and here they have a screen here, and Dennis Edwards had the shot, didn't quite make it, but the Oregon Ducks did not get the first down, and they still may have to kick.
He was a running back a couple of years ago here at Oregon. No fake. Babb will kick it. Whoops.
Too much time, possibly.
It could be. Just as Babb punted the ball, the official dropped the flag. Delay of the game against Oregon. Good snap. Babb aiming for the sideline. Timmy White at the 10. Up to the 15. To the 20. Rockshani moves out. First and 10 SC at the 21. Allen, or check it, it's McKenzie. The pitch to Allen. 25. Tries to go to the outside, and right there with him is Mike Walder, the defensive end, pulling him down at the USC 30. Alan Pugh back in at center. Slayton goes out. loss on the play of 3 yards. And now SC will have to punt. Good snap from Limebaugh. The boot by Pryor. The wind holding it up. It hits at the 42 and is downed by Marvin Williams at the 42. First and 10, Oregon. Ball just shy of the 43 of the Ducks. Ogburn turns around on the option. He will carry. 45-50 down into SC territory. Out of bounds at the 44 of USC. Oh, what a spark this young man, Ogburn, gives this Oregon team.
You know, it's exciting to see an athlete do this for a team, let alone a town. Here's Ogden, just runs a misdirection play, reverse the other way, then runs with his great ability at 9.45-40 speed.
First down for Oregon at the 44 of USC. And if you're wondering about a field goal attempt by Oregon, Jolly Moore, a senior filling in for Pat English, is on the sidelines, and he would have the wind at his back.
And he has the stronger leg of the two kickers also, Michael.
First and 10, the ball at the SC 44, 7-7 tie, 2 minutes left. Into the middle goes Reggie Brown, not much there, maybe a yard or two. Back is Terrence Jones, the tailback is Reggie Brown. Ogburn sprinting out, and he's going to be dropped at the 44 by Georgia Chica. A loss of two.
Coach Brooks is irate. Steve Busick came like a late hit, no call. And if I was Brooks, I would be screaming also.
Mosier wide to the right side. In the slot to the right is Kurt Jackson. Ogburn wants to throw long. It's intercepted by Ronnie Lott at the 40, 45, 50. Ronnie Lott down to the 45. And the Trojans have one last chance with 52 seconds left.
Can I say it? Just great playing, great effort. When the Trojans are in trouble, it seems like nothing's impossible or everything is impossible. One of the safeties, Ronnie Lott or Dennis Smith, comes in. And here we have Ronnie Lott makes the crucial play, read the quarterback all the way, makes the nap, and gets the crucial 15 or 20 yard gain.
That's the fifth intercepted pass this year for Ronnie Lott. He had three against Minnesota late in September. Now the Trojans with a first down at the 45 of Oregon. 52 seconds left. Adams wants to throw, looks for Brenner. Here he dumps it off over to the tailback, Allen. Allen is out of bounds. Trojans with a first down at the Oregon 33. Adams to pass, looking for Williams. Adams steps up. He's going to run with the ball. Adams at the 32. Out of bounds at the 30. That'll stop the clock with 36 seconds left. The call is personal foul against SC 15. 7-7 tie. 36 seconds left. First and 25 for the Trojans. Everybody out. Here goes Adams. He throws over the head of Jeff Simmons at the 45. Simmons covered by Brian Hinkle with that much time left. Kevin Williams wide to the left side. Adams looking for Williams. Here they come. Adams throws. He avoids the sack. He was throwing forward as he was being pulled down by Sutterland. Adams with presence of forethought managed to get that arm going forward and threw it to the ground.
And there he's looking, and like so often today, he couldn't find anybody, but he has enough composure to throw the ball.
Brooks wanted intentional grounding to be called against Adams. No grounding call. It's third and 35 with 24 seconds left from the USC 41. Ball is snapped, penalty markers go down, and it's going to be a penalty against, apparently, USC.
Adams is looking down to his right. The ball is snapped, and I know he didn't have full control of the ball.
21 seconds to go, 7-7 tie. Kevin Williams sprinting down the left sidelines. He's forced out of bounds. Adams steps up, and he throws, and it is going to be incomplete. Throwing for Kevin Williams at the 35.
Trojans had a tough time, Mike, on punting before, and people have been blitzing him. So this is a question if they're going to try and block this punt.
Ten guys are coming. Pryor gets it away. Choo-choo just runs away from the ball. Choo-choo Young, as the ball will be downed at the 18 with 4 seconds left. Trojans, they can't go to the Rose Bowl. Pac-10 penalties. Their hope is for a national championship that is about to go out the window because of the tie.
That's a great observation, but you never know. This is a long season. Alabama may get tied or maybe get beaten. And I know this would be a pleasant surprise for the Ducks, but it has to kind of shock some of the Trojan fans.
And then it's up to Stanford
The Washington Huskies in the Coliseum on the 15th. UCLA on the 22nd. Notre Dame December the 6th. Back to throw long and deep is Ogburn. It almost is intercepted by Dennis Smith. Ogburn was throwing to the flanker, Mark James. That's it. The game is over.
We're going.
Rich Brooks, the head coach at Oregon, against a former Oregon player and assistant coach, John Robinson of SC. And it winds up a standoff. Oregon 7, USC 7, a final from Hudson Stadium.